accepts from us that as a form of jihad, that we are struggling against tyrants and rulers, not only abroad in the Middle East or in the other side of the world, but here in these United States of America, where you have fascists and white supremacists and Islamophobes reigning in the White House.
Sarsour supporters maintain the word causing fierce backlash has been taken out of context, and that she's also been fighting back, tweeting, "Right wing tries to demonize my leadership. Editing videos is their favorite pastime." Here now, Ben Shapiro is editor-in-chief of DailyWire.com, and Hassan Shibley is chief executive director of CARE Florida, a friend of Ms. Sarsour's, and was president when she made the comment. So, Hassan, let me start with you. Tell me how it was taken out of context.
Well, jihad means to struggle for good, and she was very clear that it's our duty as Americans and as Muslims to put forward our best effort and to struggle to speak truth to power, to help the disenfranchised, to stand for the oppressed, no matter what the cost is of speaking out. And she's actually paying the price of speaking out and calling out the Trump administration's attacks on minorities, attacks against women. Linda's a revolutionary American Muslim proud hijab sporting activist, and we stand with her. We're proud of the tremendous work she's doing to stand with all disenfranchised minorities to make America great by standing for justice and speaking truth to power, which is exactly what jihad is about.
Okay, so I first read about this on the Daily Wire when you wrote about it, Ben. Tell me why you think that it was not taken out of context when she calls for a jihad against the White House.
Well, I mean, it clearly wasn't taken out of context. Everybody I know who posted this story posted the entire video as well as a large portion of the transcript from what she said. I don't think anybody is claiming that she openly called for violence against President Trump, but jihad means more than just internal struggle or quote-unquote struggle for good. I mean, we all know that there are terrorists all over the world who invoke the word jihad as justification for what they do, and Linda Sarsour knows that, too. I mean, she knows how to make a headline. She is a radical anti-Semite who has backed terrorists in the past. She's a person who has said that I am
her
standing.
You're a woman who's not here to defend herself. You just don't like a vocal American Muslim woman proudly standing for justice. Don't smear a woman who's not here to defend herself. Shame on you.
Okay, I'll talk about CARE instead. CARE is an organization that was an unindicted co-conspirator in the Holy Land.
Right, shift the topic. Exactly. Never indicted. Don't try to drown out the conversation. Let's talk about what jihad means. Jihad means striving for truth.
Let me ask you, Hassan.
That's exactly what she
did. If you want to talk about context, let's talk about the full context.
Yes, go ahead and ask me.
Okay, this is what I want to ask you.
The fact that she began this speech by praising a guy who has in the past talked about how jihad includes violent jihad. She started her speech with that. So let's not pretend that you can just, you're the one taking this one line out of context and then suggesting that it only refers
to some sort of anti-version jihad. Well, I encourage everybody just to listen to the speech for herself.
So I listen to it, and I have a question to you from a communication standpoint. So she wants to be an effective activist. Surely she is aware that when the general public hears the word jihad, it's not necessarily about an internal struggle and standing up for people's rights. I mean, we do that all the time in America, like our country's actually built on that. So I'm curious why she doesn't think that she would get some backlash. If you're gonna say those things, you are going to get, you know, stir up a hornet's nest.
Well, that's why it's so important that she used that word, because we must reclaim that word from the extremists that have misdefined it and misrepresented it. So Muslim extremists and anti-Muslim extremists have both hijacked and distorted jihad to mean something horrible, to mean exactly what jihad does not mean, actually. And the only way we can reclaim our words and reclaim our language is by leaders proudly and unapologetically using it in the right context so we can show the world what jihad really means. Jihad does not mean war, qital, and how it means war.
Whistling past the graveyard, because that's already the reclamation, Ben, is too late for that.
Of course,
no, it isn't too late. It isn't too late. It isn't too late.
Okay, if it isn't too late, then I'd like to hear CARE come out right now and condemn the Muslim Brotherhood.
Why would we condemn the Muslim Brotherhood? We don't condemn political organizations. Listen, let's not again. Every single time you want to try to distort the conversation. Why don't you condemn the KKK? Why don't you condemn the Lord's Resistance Army? Every time a Muslim comes up, you start asking Muslims to condemn. Muslims are human beings. We're proud Americans. We stand for peace. We stand for justice. We condemn all people. We condemn all people who engage in violence against human beings, against civilians. And take that for granted. We are one humanity, one people. Let's get to know each other. Let's not promote fear and hate of each other.
All right, Hassan, I'll give the last word to you, Ben.
Okay, if you want to reclaim the word jihad, you should start by condemning organizations that promote jihad all over the world instead of associating with them,
Again, you're misdefining jihad. Jihad means standing for justice. Jihad means standing for justice. It doesn't mean terrorism. And we stand against all terrorists and all those who engage in violence.
Organizations that participate in it. This is not hard.
We have and we do, just as everybody else does. Thank you.
Linda Sarsour is a Muslim political activist who co-chaired the Women's March in Washington this past January. In an interview with The Nation magazine, she said a person cannot support Israel and be a feminist because, quote, you either stand up for the rights of all women, including Palestinians, or none. Well, that has several pro-Israel feminists irate. Big Bang Theory star Mayim Bialik, if indeed that's her name, said Wednesday that, quote, the left needs to re-examine the microscope they used to look at Israel, for sure. Comedian Roseanne Barr tweeted this, is it even possible to be a pro-Palestinian feminist? Sarsour isn't selective in her wrath, by the way. In January, she said that ex-Muslim feminist Ayan Hirsi Ali should have her genitalia taken away from her for criticizing Islam. Notably, Ali is herself a victim of female genital mutilation. You couldn't make that up. It's too horrible. Well, that's it for us tonight.
Sarsour, where she talked about, Linda Sarsour, for those who don't know, is the Women's March organizer and radical Islamist who spent last Sunday, a week ago, she spent last Sunday talking about why Muslims need to fight a jihad against Trump. She said a jihad meant a word of truth against a dictator or a tyrant, but she used the word jihad advisedly because obviously jihad has broader meaning. So on Friday night, I was on with Dana Perino on Fox News, and she had on also a spokesperson from CAIR, the Council on American Islamic Relations. Now, number one, it is necessary to note that Council on American Islamic Relations is, in fact, a group that has been linked with the Muslim Brotherhood. A lot of their founders were associated with the Muslim Brotherhood. They were linked with the Holy Land Foundation trial in 2007. The Holy Land Foundation was sending money to terrorist groups, and CAIR was linked with them. CAIR has been named as a terrorist group, actually, by the United Arab Emirates. So they are a very nefarious group, and yet they are the ones out there defending Linda Sarsour. What was irritating about this interview was that it was very difficult to get a word in edgewise because this guy decided to talk over me. But you can see the same people who say they're moderate refuse blatantly, point blank, to condemn the Muslim Brotherhood or even Hamas. You'll see it during this interview.
I don't think anybody is claiming that she openly called for violence against President Trump, but jihad means more than just internal struggle or quote-unquote struggle for good. I mean, we all know that there are terrorists all over the world who invoke the word jihad as justification for what they do, and Linda Sarsour knows that too. I mean, she knows how to make a headline. She is a radical anti-Semite who has backed terrorists in the past. She's a person who has said that I am
personally... Stop smearing her. Don't smear a woman who's not here to defend herself. Proudly standing for justice. Don't smear a woman who's not here to defend herself. Shame on you.
Okay, I'll talk about CAIR instead. CAIR is an organization that was an unindicted co-conspirator in the Holy Land.
Right, shift the topic. Exactly. Never indicted. Don't try to drown out the conversation. Let's talk about what jihad means.
Jihad means driving. I want to point out what happened right there in the interview. So he says, don't attack Linda Sarsour. She's not there to defend herself. First of all, he was there to defend her. That was the entire topic of the segment. Second of all, I said, okay, I won't attack Linda Sarsour. I'll attack you. And then he said, stop shifting topic. I just want to point out how dumb a tactic that is. It continues along these lines.
And that's exactly what
Hassan,
she's doing.
Let me ask
you
something.
If you want to talk about context, let's talk about the full context.
Yes, go ahead and ask
which
you.
Is who
okay, what I, this is what I want to ask you.
The fact that she began this speech by praising a guy who has in the past talked about how jihad includes violent jihad. She started her speech with that. So let's not pretend that you can just, you're the one taking this one line out of context and then suggesting that it only refers
to
some
sort of anodyne
version of
jihad. Well, I encourage everybody just to listen to the speech for herself.
If you want to reclaim the word jihad, you should start by condemning organizations that promote jihad all over the world instead of associating with them, praising
Why
them,
would we,
and talking
we,
about
Again, you're misdefining jihad. Jihad means standing for justice. Jihad means standing for justice. It doesn't mean terrorism. And we stand against all terrorists and all those engaged in violence.
Organizations that participate in it. This is not hard.
And that was the point. He wouldn't. I asked him point blank, will you condemn the Muslim Brotherhood? No, why would we? Would you condemn the KKK? And I went, yeah, of course I'd condemn the KKK. Why the hell wouldn't I condemn the KKK? Who are you talking to here? Are you kidding me? The KKK ain't exactly my best friends, gang. So it just demonstrates the double game that's being played by a lot of the people on the left and a lot of the people in the Islamic world in order to defend people who really are quite extreme. Linda Sarsour is very extreme. Linda Sarsour, we talked about her entire resume last week, but now she has a piece in the Washington Post talking about how she's a victim. Who's she a victim of? Well, here she says that she's a victim of xenophobes, of course, but she was a little clearer on Twitter. She said that it was white supremacists and it was white supremacists and Zionists who are the people targeting her. Yeah, that sounds really tolerant of you. It sounds like you're a real tolerant person. Linda Sarsour said, this week, conservative media outlets took a speech I gave to the largest gathering of Muslims in America out of context and alleged that I had called for a violent jihad against the president. I did not. First of all, no one suggested that she called for a violent jihad against the president. We suggested that she used the word jihad, which has violent connotations to lots of people all over the world, and that she knew that when she said it, specifically because she started the speech by thanking a guy who had openly embraced violent jihad in the past. She said, sadly, this is not a new experience for me. Since the Women's March on Washington, which I had the privilege of co-chairing with inspirational women from across the country, my family and I have received countless threats of physical violence. Would those threats of physical violence be, you know, along the lines of saying that Ayaan Hirsi Ali should have her vagina removed, which is legitimately what Linda Sarsour said about Ayaan Hirsi Ali, a female genital mutilation victim? She says, the reason is that I am their worst nightmare. She's our worst nightmare. She's not my nightmare. She's my dream. I hope every Democrat embraces Linda Sarsour. I hope every Democrat decides that Linda Sarsour must run for public office on the platform of jihad just means internal struggle against tyrants. Sure. Let's find out. She says, in my speech, I sent not a call to violence, but a call to speak truth to power and to commit to the struggle for racial and economic justice, except for the Juden. I was speaking to an all-Muslim audience. As an American, I should be free to share and discuss scripture and teachings of my beloved prophet. Okay, you were. No one said you should be shut up. In fact, I would like for you to talk more. So I'm glad that she was writing here. She said, the attack from xenophobes and conservative media have continued. It saddens me deeply that my three children are frightened. Okay, maybe you shouldn't say crazy things. This would not be a justification in any way of violent threats against anyone. In fact, this is sort of what I am decrying here, is you using the word jihad in an advised way in order to be deliciously vague and deliberately vague about the nature of violence. She actually talked about how she hoped that Allah would accept her resistance to Trump as a form of jihad. A form of jihad, not the entirety of jihad, a form of jihad, right? One form among many, meaning that she accepts the possibility of other forms of jihad. She says, dissent is the highest form of patriotism, and I intend to continue to push my country to respect the rights of all of its citizens. I will not be silenced. By the way, she says that Zionists, pro-Israel people, cannot be feminists because, of course, they are Zionists, and Zionists are evil. So, once again, Linda Sarsour, beloved of the Democratic Party, if this is something that they want to, if this is where they...